Better than anyone, I know what you are capable of. But I also know what you're not capable of. Remember years ago when you were making a name for yourself, you claimed you had ruthless aggression. Well, if you had it then, you don't have it anymore. Because if you did, you would have put me in the hospital last Monday night on Raw. But you didn't. You couldn't do it. You didn't have the stomach. And you're going to regret that decision for the rest of your life after this Sunday. Now, last week, John, you said that I had all the God-given natural ability in the world, but that I had gotten lazy. I did not get lazy. Sometimes, when you're that much better than all of your peers, you lack motivation, you get complacent. But John, John, fear not. I have all the motivation I need to beat your ass this Sunday at TLC, hanging right here. You say that you don't care about being the face of the WWE, but that's a lie. I know you, John. Image is everything to you. But you're going to be the man that lost the most important match in the history of the WWE. Meanwhile, meanwhile, I am the greatest superstar of this generation or any other. Just look around you. Look at these men in this ring. Look at Mick Foley back there. Look at Mick. Hey, Mick, I took years off of his career. I took years, literally years, off of his life. Where's HBK? Showstopper, Shawn Michaels. Mr. WrestleMania, I've embarrassed him on multiple occasions. And there wouldn't have even had to have been a screw job in Montreal if I was competing 16 years ago. Where are you, Brett? Because I would have left you laying unconscious in the middle of that ring. John Cena, I need you to understand something. This Sunday at TLC, everything that you have worked so hard for, everything that you have fought so hard for, will come crashing down all around you.
It's funny. I couldn't help but notice you said the word work. Little example for 1 second. Tell these people your name, please.
My name is Daniel Bryan.
We'll get to know you a little bit more. Daniel, where are you from?
I'm from Aberdeen, Washington.
Wherever that is.
Was either your father or your mother a superstar, Hall of Fame, WWE superstar at all? Father or mother, either one.
No, my dad's a log scaler, actually.
What?
So since you've been here, you've had to work for everything you've got.
Yes.
You hear that? The reason they cheer for him is because he works and he earns it. A guy like you has been given every single I'm about to hit you in the face with some truth. Ever since you came to the WWE Training Center, you were untouchable. You were bulletproof. You couldn't be fired. Nobody could touch Randy Orton because they liked you. And then you get to the WWE, and what happens? You get sheltered by the best performer in the business. Nothing's changed, Randy. All you do is hide behind Triple H. All you do is hide behind Stephanie McMahon. And you got the balls to stand in this ring and say you're better than anybody here? Say you're bigger than all of this? You have always blamed everybody else for your failures. You've pointed fingers and you've made excuses. You've had behavior problems in the ring. You've had behavior problems outside the ring. And the sad thing is, the TLC match this Sunday is the biggest in WWE history. That's why everybody is here tonight. This changes the very course of the WWE. But you want these championships because you're selfish, because you feel you deserve it. And maybe, just maybe, if you hold on to this, you can finally walk around with the rest of the superstars and say, hey guys, look, I'm finally what I was supposed to be 10 years ago. Every single time I have held either of these championships, my business card reads the same. You want some? Come get some. And here's the real truth. Whether these guys in the ring like me or not, they respect me because they know it. Whether it's Triple H or it's Shawn Michaels in a WrestleMania match, whether it's Booker T, hell, nobody wanted to give Dolph Ziggler a chance. What did I do? I said, let's fight. Everybody said it was a bad idea to give CM Punk a championship match when he was gonna leave the WWE. All I saw was the best in the world. Hell, the only legitimate championship shot Daniel Bryan's ever had was against me, and he won. So I'll say it right here in front of your hometown. If I win on Sunday, I look forward to the rematch, a fair rematch. You see, that's what being a champion is all about, a certain level of respect. And last week, I wasn't gonna take you out. I just wanted to make a statement that when the chips are down, I can be just as brutal as you. So right now, I'm gonna make one more statement because I know exactly what this means. This Sunday will be physical and it will be brutal, and I will be at my very best. I just hope you are too, because after this Sunday, the last thing anyone is gonna wanna deal with is just another Randy Orton excuse. Good luck on Sunday. You're gonna need it.
Oh, and Orton with a cheap shot. And here comes